खत्म कर
अभी तो ट्वीट करेगा
a silent phone lecture okay so the privilege that money gave you I will not do that so I also said you can so please keep your phone on silent if it is not already on silent okay gentlemen set it off quickly photograph or photographs like this is you know quite often seen in your corridor because you call the haunting so I also decided that you know the first photograph should be from the James Bond series you know it will be some trivia some 52 movies of James Bond has been made over you know 54 years that means every 2 years there has been one James Bond movie and when we were growing up James Bond was pretty much the hottest thing that was available to see right now you know you have got enough things available on your telephones so when I was growing up you know this guy with that circle there what's his name
Roger Moore
right and who was the first Bond
Sean Connery
you know the guy who's next to him
yes George Lazenby
no this guy this
Timothy Dalton
even I did not know you know is George Lazenby he did only one movie okay and after him
Timothy Dalton
and the present Bond. So when we were growing up, James Bond was a big thing, you know, and we couldn't like go and see James Bond just like that. We had to jump school, not tell our parents, and we were not really interested in seeing James Bond. We were more interested in seeing the people who acted with him. So you know, and there was no social media really those days, you know. So we just read Roger Moore. So Moore, who decides it is Moore or Moore? So there was nobody, you know, when you went and saw the movie, you also said Roger Moore. So like all you know, classes and all group of people, you know, every class, every group of people has got one smart aleck. You know. So when we were getting, you know. Confused about what should he be called, so one guy suddenly got up and said, "His name is Roger Moore." And I said, "Theek hai, Moore." It happened. Moore went on for 4-5 years because Roger Moore acted in the maximum number of James Bond movies. And then there was a doubt as to whether Roger Moore means he must be from Satara or somewhere. I said, "Yes. His father is from Satara. Mother is an Englishwoman." What explains that blue eyes? So there are enough GSPs in Maharashtra who got that blue eyes. So it went on for quite a number of years. We believed he was Roger Moore. We thought he was half Indian, half Shiv Sena, whatever. Till you know, people from my generation started going abroad. And then they came back and said, "Arey yaar, Moore mat bolna, besti hogi," you know. And then we realized it is Moore. And so is the difference in the generation. And so is the difference in social media. I don't think anybody will ever make a mistake of pronouncing anybody's name wrongly, because you've got so many platforms. You know, I am an ex-armed forces officer. I was in the Indian Navy. I retired as a commander. So was James Bond. James Bond is also commander of the Royal Navy. No similarities after that. So I decided to do an MBA. Okay, so when I decided to do the MBA, I was in my 40s, not young, some years back, and being in the armed forces, I never really went to a college, so I had gone to the academy at 16 and a half years of age, and when guys and girls were doing what they had to do in college, we were doing push-ups, so I was like really very excited to go back to college, you know, whenever I got the opportunity. So the college was Narsi Bonjing Villaparle. And I went there and I had some, you know, young people like you doing the course with me, and I said I should be able to connect. Connect with them, you know. So but funny thing, oh, you know, I wore my full sleeve shirt and nice trouser and black shoes, and I went and I wanted to get friendly with them. So I saw one guy in a class like this, and I said, "Hi, dude, how are you?" He looked at me straight like this. "The uncle, it is not dude, it is dude." "Why?" "Badi sharam hai." "You know, this guy has called me uncle, I am not going to leave him." So I went home, told my wife, "Come on, let's go shopping. I need to really change my wardrobe. I need to buy a pair of jeans, a good pair of jeans." So we went to one of the shops, and I said, "Kuch achha batao yaar, naya wala, jo aajkal ke log pehante hain." He was thinking that, why am I asking this? Then after, you know, a lot of conversation, he got me one jeans. And he said, "Ki sir, ye pehno, ye hai latest." "Bole, ye toh phata hua hai." "Nahi sir, this is called ripped jeans." "But you're going to sell this?" Said, "Sir, when you buy it and it gets torn, it is called torn jeans. When we sell it torn, it is called ripped jeans." I bought it nevertheless, went home. And, you know, wore that to college the next day, you know, with a lot of my hairy thighs showing next day, but I was still not accepted. I need to do more. Exactly where the generation gap is. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to speak to you about the generation gap. Let's understand what a generation is all about. What is the difference between your generation and my generation? What is your generation called? What are the challenges and how do we overcome it? So, well, generations are, you know, roughly classified like this. The silent generation, the people who were there before 1900s. No great documentation, they came, they went, no great discussion. The lost generation, this was from 1900s to about 45, 46. The First World War and the Second World War. So a lot of people died during this war, and that's why it's called the lost generation. Then both the wars got over, and then came a generation called baby boomers. Why they called baby boomers? Anybody heard of all this? No. Well, the wars got over, people came home, they had a lot of time, they started making babies. 70% of the US population happened during this time. 70%. But then there was a, you know, flip side to it. Because if so many people are born in one period, then they are also going to get old in a particular period. So, you know, healthcare costs would increase. So, that is why that is called the baby boomer generation till about 63, 64. And then the next generation, Gen X, that is late 60s till about early 80s. Yours truly. And thereafter. Thereafter we got the millennials, and you are the millennials. We also call them Gen Y. So Victor Hugo, a French philosopher in the 17th century, said a very profound thing, very powerful. He said, "There is nothing more powerful than an idea whose time has come." And this idea is the millennials. In India, 65% of our population is below the age of 30-35. And we need to understand this population so well, because these are our workforces. If you do not know how to handle this force, well, no country can get ahead. Well, this is what a millennial looks like. Does any one of you look like this? After working hours? On a Saturday, Sunday? Why not? I want to look like this. Why not? They are very smart looking. Well, this is the evolution from monkey to the millennials. And the millennials think we are the monkeys. Okay, because they are very good in technology. So the millennials think we are the monkeys. And we think you are also proud like a monkey on the computer. So, you know, it's a mutual, you know, dislike for each other, or like for each other, or a mutual, you know, what should I say, doubt about each other.
महेंद्र और राइट में जाओ, राइट में ले चेयर
फाई करो,
no difficulty with that. 70% of them are millennials. How do 70% millennials follow this buffoon?
Money.
Why? How? What is the problem? Okay, so this room might say that no. Maybe before he was caught, some other hand would have gone up. But somebody would have got upset. So this is it. The difficulty.
महेंद्र
Well, you know, a generation, when we say a generation, it is about a period of 30 years. And in a period of 30 years, you're supposed to be born, you study, you go to work, you get married, and then you have children. Very simple, isn't it? In my generation, which is called the Gen X, about 85 to 90% of us completed all these four activities by the time we were 30. Alright. Here, the world average is about 11%. And in India, it's like about 20-22%. So, the millennials, when they cross the age of 30, some of them definitely have not married. Some of them, even if they are married, they don't have kids. And some of them have stopped working only. Too boring. So this is exactly where the difference is. So when Gen X would start going to school, he had his next 30 years in his mind. At this age, I will stop studying. At this age, I will get married. At this age, I will have kids. At this age, I'll buy a house or whatever. The normal, traditional, standard stuff. I'm not telling this is bad, but this is the difference. This is how we think millennials are. Okay. Well, we think, and the world thinks, and the corporations, the world over think, that millennials are tough to manage. They are
entitled.
They feel very entitled. Yes. ये तो होना ही चाहिए. Lazy, unfocused, self-obsessed, moody, and unreasonably ambitious.
Yes.
Want to count from climb Mount Everest in a day? Does not happen. So what do the millennials want? Meaningful, purposeful. They need to make an impact. Whatever that means. Flexi working hours.
Free food.
At the end of the day, very, very understanding bosses. Alright. So, lot of corporations said, okay, theek hai yaar. They asked, a lot of consultants, then they asked them, they said this. But theek hai na, koi baat. Deal hai to lao. Khana khilao. Flexi working hours karo. Kya problem? Let's do it. We do it in TC22. Let's go. So I work in TC22. And then I ask a lot of millennials there.
I heard you guys get Apple every day.
Yes. So we get Apple twice a day.
we have 2-3 jars where food for you and you know, chana is there or some small okay. So all this is kept. So I asked somebody, here, isn't it fantastic that we are getting all this? So in the coffee room, one of them told me, sir, yeah, sir, roj apple dete hain. सर कभी तो ऑरेंज भी देना चाहिए होगा एप्पल का सर एप्पल पे वैक्स देखो कितना मैं तो रोज छुरी लेकर आता हूँ वैक्स निकालता हूँ फिर खाता हूँ वो मूंगफली वगैरह भी होते हैं कहाँ मूंगफली है सर खाली चना ही चना है उसका ऐसा व्हाट अबाउट द फ्रूट जूसेस दे गिव सर रोज लीची पिलाते हैं ऐसा थोड़ी होता है नाउ TC22 इज द ओनली बिल्डिंग व्हिच गेट्स दिस ओके सो देयर आर डिफिकल्ट Flexi hours, there are flexi hours. But you know, I'll give you another example. But there is a missing piece. The generation is not very happy with whatever happens or is given to them, and there has to be a reason for that. So I would probably, you know, look at it as parenting. There is a difficulty. The kind of parenting that we were used to, and the kind of parenting that we have done, so it's very different. Technology, of course, Manish may or may not agree with me at the end of it, has played a major part in this.
It has, sir.
Instant gratification and environment, we'll all discuss this one by one. Well, now, the millennials have grown up, in an environment where they feel that we are special. They will get whatever they want and their parents will make that happen for them. Okay, so they are very, very special. That's why you have names like Prince and all. Spend 1 hour with the kid or 2 hours before the kid goes to sleep and spend 1,000 rupees during that 2 hours. What do you want? I want this bite. What do you want? I want that bite. You know, it's an entitled generation who has never heard a no in their life. Then the parents had certain views. My child can never be wrong. Okay. My child is always to be given the best. My child is very sensitive. So you can't shout at the child. And my child has to become global citizen. So the whole training is around these things. So what happens is, you have a child who comes back from school, then the child goes to music class, thereafter karate class, thereafter dance class and whatever class. So child is more busier than the parents. The parents come at 8 o'clock, child comes at 8:30. And he's Superman. Okay. At the end of the day, they think that this guy will just go. So that is how it is. Now. Because in our kind of country, these skills are passed from generation to generation. So today when you go to look for an electrician, he's not a Telugu. And if he comes out, he says, sir, 2000 rupees chahiye. He's earning more. He's earning more than an engineer. Okay, but we have to make somebody an engineer. So I am not an engineer myself, and I have, you know, met some engineering guys, and they tell me that, you know, sir, it is the end of the youth. He has no talent for anything mechanical. He has no talent for anything electronic. But then, engineer nahi banega to kya karega? You are considered a failure if you do a BSc. A loser. Okay. So this is engineering, and thereafter, only an engineer is of no use. Yes, you have to do an MBA. So that is the end of home. Okay. So for basic job to be done, for a basic, you know, entry point into the corporate, you have to be a BTech MBA. Right? So, you know, and most of these guys after doing this engineering and MBA end up selling soaps or something like that, you know, Procter & Gamble or something. For no reason, you know. I think, what are you doing? If they go and join HDFC Bank or HSBC Bank. So one of my friends, you know, his son must be, you know, a little 2-3 years older than you. You guys are what, 21, 22?
Yes.
Okay, so he is now like 26. So he did his normal stuff of engineering and MBA. And then he joined a bank, I will not name the bank. And he went there for 4-5 months. And said, now I'm going to do now. Bother. So big drama at home, big trouble at home. And my friend gave me a call, he said, yeah, you have seen this boy grow up. The name of the boy was Prince, incidentally. And I went there. I said, beta, kya ho gaya? Why are you not going? The society cannot tell me anything. Said, why? Society told me do engineering, I did engineering. Society told me do MBA, I did MBA. Society told me go and join the bank, I joined the bank. Now I don't like it. They can't tell me anything. I said, nahi yaar. But now that you've got a job, you should go. I'm not making an impact. I said, but you've been there only for 6-7 months here. It will take some time. I have to go to the same place every day. I said, how many places can you go, right? You all have gone to the same place every day. So you have to go to the same place every day. And they asked me to come on time also. What a reasonable demand. You have to go on time. And these guys, they told me that you, Prince, go to this guy whose worth is 100 crores and go and tell him that, great, you have done a great job, you have made 100 crores, but you don't know how to handle your money. I will handle your 100 crores. So this guy who has come in an Uber share is going to go to a 100 crore guy and tell him how to handle his money. I said, what's the problem? Wo de deta kya paisa? Bolta, haan de deta hai. He believes him. And I said, what happens? Does it double, multiply? So that is the interest that guy had in the job that he was doing after going through an entire process of MBA and engineering and whatever. That guy now is with an advertising agency and doing reasonably well now. But he went through his 2 or 3 years of solid trouble. In fact, he sat at home for 1 year and, you know, refused to do any course. So what I'm trying to say is that there is a difficulty. There is no hurry in this generation to get to the next level. Next. There is another funda that, you know, this generation has. My CTC should be equal to or more than my age in lakhs. How many people agree to this?
Everyone.
What is your age got to do with CTC? Your CTC could be double. He says that I am 25 years old, my CTC should be 25 years. Well, that is the, you know, ambition with which people are climbing. They are in a big hurry, they just want to get to the next level as soon as possible, by hook or crook. And believe me, such things take time. Now we have technology piece. Okay. Manish just asked you, I think all you guys are on all these platforms, isn't it? LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter. How many of you guys are not on Facebook? So now, technology is addictive. Technology is addictive and social media certainly is addictive. There is no doubt. Research has shown. So, is technology bad? Is social media bad? No. Too much of social media is bad. Okay. Too much of anything is bad. So when I talk about addiction, you know, whether it is smoking, drinking, gambling, it all gives you a high, isn't it? Gives you a high. That's why people do it. And what is a high? A high is because your body releases a chemical called dopamine. Okay, which makes you feel good. Okay, so if it is making you feel good, you are going to do it again and again and again. And at some point in time, you become addicted to it. You just see this family. Dada ji piche, bachche aage, and the mother and father. There is no conversations which are happening. In fact, there is no need for any conversations. Everything is possible without speaking. Even in corporates, when we go for meetings and different meetings with people from different teams, you don't even chat with each other. Before the meeting starts, everybody is on his phone doing whatever he has to do. Somebody says, meeting started, meeting started. This is not how relationships are. This is not how people remain stable. Okay. Everything cannot be done on while that facility or that thing is available to you at a click of a button. But there is a need to have deep rooted relationships. And you have to develop the skills for that. Okay, Manish just told you that, you know, you are the sum average of 5 people who are following you or something. I had gone to a hospital recently and, you know, one of the drug companies was advertising, you know, their product. I quite liked that tagline. It was outside the psychiatry ward. So they said that only one in four people in this world are fully normal mentally. Only one in four people in this world are fully normal. So if you have got 3 friends and if you think all of them are fine, then there is a problem. Okay, so you have to understand this in the right perspective. Okay.
Electronic dance music.
That's all.
Yeah. Lots of people.
I don't think I'm speaking to the baby
here.
So others have heard about it or not?
Yes. Pani chair. Yeah.
It's a very vague thing. So I went to Goa once and I went to a place called Window. So, my wife is very interested in all these things with millennial food. Some of our friends had landed up and she said that let's go to this place. And to my horror, when I went there, I realized the man, the DJ, is wearing a mask.
That's marshmallow.
I don't know why it's marshmallow. People should not recognize him or something.
But digital.
And it just goes on and on and on and on. I don't know how anybody could like this music. There's no lyrics. And everybody is doing this. She had a couple of friends who were millennials. We went there and nice flashy lights and all that. When we were growing up, there was some raspberry dinosaurs and something like that here in Chiru and all that. More than that, we have not seen anything. And this was all bright and, you know, all the lights and then music was playing. And as soon as we went there, her friend started this, you know. So for a time, my wife also, you know, and she was telling, why are you not dancing? And I'm waiting for the lyrics to come. fact of the matter is, it is impossible. It is impossible to go and do something like this. See, अपने time पे ऐसा होता था, go back.
Opera.
अच्छा वाला concert होता था, कुर्सी पे बैठते थे, सुनते थे, and घर के ले जाते थे, ताली वाली मार के. But this is something which is, you know,
insane.
You have to be at a, you know, I think the dopamine levels have to be extremely high. This generation is also used to instant gratification. You see, I am from a generation where we used to sit down on the ground like on a Sunday evening and wait for the Sunday evening movie to come on a black and white TV. And that movie, I remember, used to be at 6 o'clock in the evening. 5:45, everybody would sit down. And 15 minutes we could watch that. And very patiently. Koi hilta bhi nahi tha wahan se. 15 minute. He was talking about attention span 7 minutes. 7 seconds. I can, you know, tell you with conviction, 15 minutes to nobody would get disturbed only. And then we used to have some ads. Fabina or something, you know, nobody's moving around, just one slide wala ads. Wo sab dekh to ke aaram se picture wagera dekh lo. It was quite nice. Now, we don't have to wait for any timings. Log in, what is it, torrent? Torrent. Log in, see the movie. You don't want to see the movie there. You want to see movie outside, book my show. Okay, you don't need to talk at all. You want to buy clothes? Amazon. Okay, WhatsApp. You want to go outside? Book a Ola, book a Uber. You want to, you know, see a movie, torrent, you can, you know, do banking. Everything is from home. Why talk? Why talk at all? What is this word?
Of design strategy for that, so I know.
Yeah. So, this is, you know, Tinder and Tony Bradley for you. The good old days, you know.
Abhi to saal.
I will not get too much, but opportunity because you were, you know, get me. But the fact of the matter is, there used to be a system where boy looked at girl, girl looked at boy. Yes meant no, no means no, no means no. Yes. Everything. Boys would go and, you know, watch the Kabhi Kabhi and Silsila and, you know, remember the entire dialogue. Kabhi Kabhi mere dil mein khayal aata hai meri zindagi. Now that we from see all that. But sure. Girls would get impressed. It would take a lot of time. There was no cafe coffee day. Only your only Anna in that Udupi. And you managed to do whatever you had. But no.